Hari Om, and welcome back to Sanskrit Word of the Month. Today we will discuss the meaning of the word Sanskara. It is derived from the root Dukriyakarane, prefixed by the syllable Sam, the prefix Sam. Sam signifies Samantata, from all sides or completely, while Dukriyakarane, the root Kr, means to do, to make. So essentially, one can translate it as to completely refine in English, to make something complete or to completely refine. That is the meaning of Sanskara. And it is in this sense that it is used in the rites of passage, which we call the 16 Sanskaras, the special moments in the life of a Hindu, starting before birth, the moment of birth, where one is later given a name, and then the first time we eat rice, the first time we go to school, etc. All the leading up to either sannyasa or renunciation or marriage. And then, of course, the antyeshti, the ultimate sanskara, where our body is confined to the funeral pyre by our children or representatives. So sanskara in this sense means to completely refine. Sanskara also has another meaning in the yoga darshana, the perspective or view of yoga, which is one of the important darshanas of ancient Hindu dharma. Here sanskara means a deep-seated impression in the mind, which is the result of previous actions and gives rise to new actions, which in turn have consequences. And those consequences again leave a deep-seated impression. So it is like a cycle that continues. In perhaps modern-day psychology, we would say sanskara is the subconscious impression that is left within the mind through experiences we make. In any case, the teachings of yoga ask us to purify or to cleanse our minds so as to free them of the sanskaras, so that we release the sanskaras, we dissolve the sanskaras that are in our minds, so that we can become mukta, liberated. So here we have two completely different meanings of sanskara, one being that of a cultural refinement, which is also how we use it when we talk about sanskar being a value, a deep-seated value that we instill within ourselves, and the other, that of yoga, being a sanskara as a deep-seated impression in the mind, which we want to ultimately be liberated from, because we don't want to continue along the same patterns all the time. Thank you very much, and Hari Om.